Yes.
A player gets one good season and then he thinks he is ready to go and play abroad.
Yes.
That's the idea that they have. But I believe if they, let's say, play 2-3 good seasons, then they will be ready to go and challenge for places abroad.
Yeah.
Yeah, so they rush. They score like 15-20 goals and they think, oh, now I'm ready to go and play in Europe.
Yeah.
It's not the case. So I urge our players to first play here at least 2-3 seasons, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah? To mature enough so such that when they go out, everything will be okay. Yeah. That's what we used to do during our days.
Yes.
Yeah.
But even those who join local teams, I've seen some of the players who went to a big team like Gor Mahia, some went to Tusker,
yeah.
Others went to Bidco. Lately, I've been getting reports that quite a number of them want to come back.
Yes.
What's the difference between FC Leopards and the other local teams?
To be honest, FC Leopards is a big club.
Yeah.
It has massive following. It has goodwill from all over. Even from State House.
Yes.
You saw a few months ago, you were in State House.
Yes.
Yeah, so FC is a big club. And me, I only urge players to use Leopards as a platform to develop their careers,
yeah,
to go outside the country, because it's not good to leave FC Leopards and go to the other small teams. It's like killing your career.
Yeah.
So, but just like I said, with a little bit of patience, with a little bit of patience, because we have challenges here and there, but once players are patient, play a season or two or three, then you are ready to go for the big leagues.
Yes.
That's my advice to the younger players.
Some of the players I've talked to will keep repeating something like a very friendly atmosphere for self-development.
Yes.
Shed some light on that.
Yes.
What incentives do you give to players to be able to develop on their own without having to be forced?
No, we do mentorship. You know, most of us, if you look at our bench, have played football.
Yeah.
Me, the head coach, Lawrence, we have played football. We have been in these situations. And we tell players that discipline is what you do without anybody following you. And we always, we tell them a lot of things. Now football is paying.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a career. It's a job. It's the best job in the world.
Yeah.
Imagine being paid for something you enjoy.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not like before when people used to play for nothing.
Yeah.
Yeah, if they make a career in football, then their lives will be much, much better in the future. And yeah, that's what we try to encourage players. And as you see now, coaches are well equipped with knowledge. It's not like before, yeah?
Yeah.
So the gap is... the gap is too small between the smaller countries and the bigger countries. So we urge players always to do the right things, and their careers will be better in the future.
So it's a question of having an experienced, a qualified and experienced bench.
Yes, that's one of the reasons, I think.
Yeah. And talking about what is the relationship between the current squad and former players, some players who left maybe 20 years ago, the big names that we used to hear of, the likes of Jojo Masiga, Murila, and the like. Is there a relationship? Is there a connection?
To be honest, no. No, it's like history to them, because when the JJs and Murilas were playing, maybe some of these boys were not yet born.
Yeah.
And it also happens with our fans. The fans that we have now, they have not enjoyed the glory that Leopards used to enjoy before.
Yeah.
That's why we always urge this group of players
to
bring that joy back to the fans as well. Because current fans know that Leopards won the league last time, maybe in 1988.
Yeah.
That's like 30 years.
Yeah. And,
somebody was born 30 years ago is...
Or 20 years ago. That doesn't
exactly. So that's why we had this group of players to try and bring that glory back.
Yeah.
But they are not... they only hear of the JJs. They have never met them. They always see them maybe at stadiums, and that's it.
Yeah.
Yes.
But there is always necessary. I think you can invite some of them to come and talk to... you know, you talked about mentorship.
Yes.
By inviting them, you can actually reinforce your mentorship program, so that the boys know that there is a history here that we are fighting for.
Exactly.
Or we are defending.
Exactly.
Yeah.
We used to do that a couple of seasons before, but you know, after this corona issue, and we know football was stopped for a lot long time, and then when the league started, it was like marathons work.
Yeah.
But that's a really good point that we need to follow up.
Okay.
Yes.
So you still have about how many more matches to go? About 20 matches to go to,
yes,
to the end of the league.
Yeah. We have done 12, 13, so 5 more matches to finish the first leg.
Yeah.
Yes.
What do you expect?
It's not easy. For sure, it's not easy. We know our challenges, we know our problems. If we sort out our problems, I think we are ready to go.
Other problems, of course, are financial, not technical.
Yeah. It will always be there. It has always been there.
Yeah.
It has to come from the heart. The boys have passion to play.
Okay.
The boys want to play. They want to do the job. But just like I said, we need to sort out, especially this issue of bringing in a couple of players. It's very, very important and very, very urgent.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Gaza, thanks a lot for talking to us. We wish you the best, and we'll always keep in touch so that where Leopard goes, when it leaps with the entire following of Yamatere.
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 Thank you so
welcome.
Thank you very much. Thank you.